मॉड्यूल 3 स्क्रिबलिंग। कीप इन माइंड इज टू नॉट लेट योर एल्बो रेस्ट ऑन द टेबल बट स्लाइटली लिफ्टेड टू अलाउ एन अनऑब्स्ट्रक्टेड मूवमेंट ऑफ द हैंड। इफ यू बेंड एंड स्क्रिबल इन अ क्लोज्ड बॉडी पोस्चर द थिंग्स विदिन योर सबकॉन्शियस वुड नॉट कम आउट ऑन पेपर thus defeating the purpose of scribbling. Keep your hand supple and move it all around the paper. Fill sheets of paper scribbling either using pencil or brush. Before you start practicing how to draw the oval shape of the head, you may also try lines like this. Try all kind of lines. Make a store here of lines so that in future when you need any kind of line to complete a drawing or express yourself on paper through art, very quickly your mind will provide you with the data of different kinds of lines. Explore what kind of lines your pencil can provide you with. Draw straight lines, curved lines and short straight lines. These are basic exercises for any kind of drawing or artwork you will dwell into in the future. Be it a portrait, life study, still life study or landscape, a good line work is a prerogative. With constant practice, you will develop a good control over your hand. Your brain may command the hand to draw what it sees. Draw short horizontal lines of the same size and continue repeating these lines. You are commanding your brain to draw a line of the same length and thickness and nothing different. Now change the length of the line and continue to draw horizontal lines of that size. Now I change the command to my brain by drawing horizontal lines of the same quality but slightly lengthier than the earlier lines. I will continue to repeat this line for some time. This exercise may seem too simple, but to practice it every day will help you a great deal at many levels. After a few lines, I will change the nature of the line again. This time, stretching short heavy lines across the sheet. These are darker than the lines above, as I have increased the pressure of charcoal on paper. Continue practicing identical lines. Observe carefully how I keep changing pressure and the quality of the lines changes completely. It also helps you understand and control your material. Keep the pressure same and lengthen the line and continue the practice. Keep the length of the line same and change the pressure, making softer lines this time. Continue drawing the same line with different variations of weight and or pressure each time, making the line softer row by row. Experiment with the pressure of the charcoal, experiencing the weight it creates on the line, thereby affecting its character. What we have here are different variations of one movement lines. We reduce the weight or pressure on the charcoal stick at the bottom. For example, if you have to draw water, what sort of lines would you pick and the weight you would add to the lines to give the impression of water would be something like this. While drawing a portrait, you will come across faces with various kinds of lines running across each face. Wrinkled, soft, strong lines around the eyes, mouth and forehead. Thus practicing these lines on paper creates a memory bank of lines and helps you when you move on to the drawing portraits. We were practicing horizontal line till now. Let's try drawing vertical or oblique identical line in the same direction. This exercise is very important. These lines are the founding steps of drawing or sketching anything in future. I will change the direction of oblique lines and demonstrate ways in which you can practice this exercise. Every shape, form or objects you see around are made of these lines. The direction, texture and tonal variation of lines change to take the desired form of any object. After practicing straight lines in horizontal, vertical or oblique direction, move on to sketching freehand lines on paper. Only when your lines develop character, control and subtlety over a period of time, you will be in a position to claim that you have a memory bank of lines. When pupils change their moods, it results in a combination of different kind of lines to express that on their faces. At the time of need, you will have to pull a line to express emotions of anger, distress or happiness in your portraits. You will know which line to pull out of your memory. How to create rhythm in your lines? For that, let's draw some identical diagonal lines with curves and a gentle flow. This practice will help build a rhythm in your lines. These rhythmic lines are an extremely valuable stock in your memory bank. Time and again, you will pull these lines to express various subjects. And in portraits, you may use these to draw hair of the model too. At this point, enjoy the charcoal stick and allow yourself to move it freely. Tilt the charcoal stick and start by sketching straight vertical lines, mostly used in drawing the neck or nose while drawing a portrait. Consistently, I draw similar lines horizontally across the paper. As I mentioned before, the purpose behind such an exercise is to strengthen your memory bank with variety of lines that can be produced through movement of the material in hand, as well as the pressure you decide to apply while drawing. It refines your understanding of lines and what they can do for you. As we progress, I will begin by a vertical line, short in length, gradually increasing the height as I move on to the next vertical line, so on and so forth. As you can see, these lines results in creating a sense of perspective. As we progress to lessons about scribbling and sketching, this current practice of drawing lines will make a deeper sense in your creative understanding. You will see things around you in lines and scribbles. Or after gaining enough experience of lines through sketching, we can say you will view all objects around you as line and calculated scribble. Observe how to create a sense of perspective through lines. As perspective through lines comes in great use while drawing the beard and hair of a model during portrait study. I will demonstrate another kind of line, which are wavy in nature. These lines are very important to practice, as they will be useful not only in portrait study but in any subject of art you may choose to study later. These heavy lines will be mostly used to draw hair, roots, stems, etc. Let me draw a head and hair using the same line to explain this further. Experiment with various lines and draw whatever lines that comes to your mind, keeping the basic guideline of keeping your hand supple and elbow free. Now see how I move my hand to create circles. On a single sheet of paper, I will show several lines of different nature and character, along the demonstrating different kind of pressure and weight. Create a visual sweetness to your quality of lines and stroke. Fill sheets, old newspapers, sketchbooks, brown paper, or use any kind of discarded paper or material to draw. My hand is free and supple. The unrestricted movement of my body along with the lines allows my whole being to feel involved in the process of creation. You may use pencil other than charcoal. To scribble various lines through different medium is an essential step before you start sketching or attempt to draw portraits. Scribbling and sketching are parallel process in the making of an artist. In fact, the former evolves and matures to become imaginary drawings at a later stage. Your scribbles will eventually become creative drawings. It will be natural and spontaneous. I began sketching the same line again and diminishing it by reducing the pressure on the charcoal as it adds. You need control of the medium and your lines in order to use these lines to draw something. Challenge yourself again by reversing the pressure from light to dark. These are primary exercises required for any student. I will begin by diagonal line again. See how I use the same charcoal differently in both the rows. And the quality of the line is different each time. The control to begin and end the line at what point is also a crucial part to understand, especially in these kinds of wavy diagonal lines. The same character of line can be used horizontally. The pressure and distance between each line will create a different effect each time. It may appear like water or hair or a waterfall. It depends how you choose to apply these lines. Start by using pencil, move on to charcoal, finally progressing to gouache. Or you may also choose to use all these mediums together. Pick any medium that suits your mood, provided you work every day for several hours. Let's try scribbling using gouache or poster color. You may use a soft hairbrush too, though I prefer using a hog hairbrush for the purpose. It holds the color longer in its rough hard bristles. Try and use your brush in other ways than the usual, moving it in different directions and by holding it differently. Looking at my hand very carefully, while the brush is moving diagonally, horizontally or vertically, it is also simultaneously revolving within my fingers. Now I am drawing the same lines using a bigger brush. As the color diminishing, the quality of the lines changes too. Drawing such lines in gouache will create interest. You will feel interested in exploring lines. Practice a lot and create a rhythmic line. I am filling the page with different kind of lines. I change the direction, pressure, and size of my brush to achieve a different lay each time. Change the length of your strokes, explore your medium. And master your material and methods to know what they are capable of doing for you. I will use dry soft pistols to scribble. While doing these scribbles, do not think of anything. Keep nothing in your mind, keep yourself free. Enjoy the colors and scribbles. You may use it straight as a pencil or horizontally hold it as a block. You may smudge the pistols using your hand or cloth. Use an eraser to pick the color to create strokes in reverse. The eraser is used in a way that the white areas it reveals look like strokes in white. Smudging and erasing will create different kind of effects. Try all sorts of mediums and know your material very well through various lines and effects before you attempt to draw any drawing or portrait.